Hi, beauties. Welcome back. Today, we have our Ipsy versus Ipsy Plus. It's been, gross.
Ugh.
I don't even know, at this point, I don't even know whose hair it is because Nikki and my hair are like the same length. So it's probably just everybody's hair and the dogs included. Anyway, that was gross. Before we jump into Ipsy versus Ipsy Plus, I wanted to take a minute just to talk about the channel for a second. So we are actually coming up on our 2 years of being a channel. It's been weird lately for me, and I know that you guys have noticed that. We used to post like 5 times a week, and now it's like, you know, we're lucky to get like 5 videos up a month. And I'm really sorry. I can't really explain it other than like towards the end of 2020, you know, we were quarantined, we were waiting on a house, and so I was putting a lot of time and effort into the channel. Nikki was as well because he was home, and I kind of felt like that was all I could do. And when we got closer to the house, I kind of started getting distracted, and then I figured when we got into the house, I would get back into the swing of things, and I just haven't felt like it. And I don't know why I haven't felt like it. I haven't felt creative. I haven't felt like I wanted to do makeup on camera. I haven't felt like I had a lot to talk about on camera. And I think it's kind of one of those things where just like mentally, I'm not really sure where I am. And I don't want it to come out on camera. I don't like I'm not in a bad place, but I'm not in a good place. You know, I just feel like lost. Like I'm happy in a lot of ways and I'm not in a lot of ways. And it's just, I don't know if that makes any sense to you guys, but I want you to know that I love you so dearly and I read all of your comments, and even if I'm not responding or if I'm not, you know, answering messages the way I used to, you guys mean the world to us and this channel means the world to us. And the last thing I want to do is like let the channel fizzle out because I'm in a bad mental state at the moment. Because we worked really hard to get here and we're really happy to have the community we've established, but yeah, so I'm sorry. I'm trying really hard to figure out like what the next step is, like new creative videos, different things other than makeup, different things other than beauty that we could do that I might like, I don't know, like feel more motivated to film. I don't know how to explain it. And I don't know if it makes any sense or not. But yeah, I just wanted to say that because I've been feeling, I feel guilty not filming for you guys. I feel guilty not posting regularly. I hate that. And I feel like I'm letting you guys down. I feel like I'm letting myself down. So it's just been weird. I'm sorry, that's like a heavy start to the video. If you're new, what a video to start out on. But yeah, so thank you guys so much for 2 years. Thank you so much for your continuous support. We love you so much, and I'm sorry, I'm working on it. Let's jump into the video itself. So Ipsy versus Ipsy, if you are new and you stayed through that, good God, thank you. Maybe subscribe, because at this point I feel like you just are part of the family now. So anyway, Ipsy versus Ipsy. I have an Ipsy subscription, both Plus and Standard. My mother does as well. So every month I take our 2 bags for the respective ones. These are our Plus this time. And I compare the 2 products. I normally like to pick out my 5 favorite products, and I like to pick out my favorite bag. I'm going to say for this one going into it, my mother flat out has been unhappy with Ipsy Plus and somewhat Ipsy Standard, but mainly Ipsy Plus the entire year. When they were over here, it was Nikki's birthday, they were over here to celebrate, and she dropped off this bag and she said, "This is the worst one I've received all year." And I was like, oh God. So I don't know what to expect for it. I'm assuming I'm probably gonna like mine better, because I was actually very happy with how my Plus ended up coming together this time. So we'll see. That's normally what I like to do, but I'm kind of going into this like, I'm just curious to see what she got that she really hated. She was like, "These were like the best options I could find. Don't like any of them, would never buy them in store." And I was like, okay, all right. So I always start with hers, and hers is over here. So we're gonna just jump in and away we go. I love the bag. I thought the bag was so cute. Love the design of it with little like emojis. And I just thought, oh gosh. And I felt like it was so summery and cute. It's a nice little material as well. So precious, love it. She did say no, she got no palettes, no sort of like makeup type thing at all offered to her. So no, you know, like blushes or contour palettes or anything like that, nothing. Which was weird because I actually ended up getting 3 eyeshadow palettes in my bag because I had 3 different choices and I liked all of them. So in different customization things, I chose them. So very weird, don't really know why that would be, because I think she has her preferences set to say that she does like eyeshadow palettes as well, but I don't. So the first thing we have is from Feel Cosmetics. This is a vitamin E balm. And I'm thinking this is a lip protection. Oh no, okay, so it's just for all skin uses. It's a natural skin protective complex of castor seed oil and sunflower wax, meant to moisturize dry lips and skin. So yeah, during summer, makes sense. I do understand why she's kind of like, meh, not a bad product, but not necessarily something I would be excited about. I do understand that. The next thing we have is from Mophilim. I've never heard of this brand before. M-A-A-P-I-L-I-M. Mophilim, that's what I'm going with. It's an eye cream with quinoa and vitamin C. It's only half a fluid ounce, so it's kind of a tiny little sample made with coriander seed and marjoram. And that's interesting, actually. So my mom, tangent, my mom is AIP, which is a highly restrictive diet. She has suffered with autoimmune diseases for my entire life. And one of her side effects was just like unnatural carrying of weight. I don't know how it's, because she didn't really gain weight. She just was heavy. And now you look at pictures of her and she was heavy because it was clearly bloat. So 2 years ago, she went AIP and lost half her body weight. Literally just, it looks amazing now. But one of the things that she can't have on this very restrictive diet is a seed of any kind, including coriander seed. So I'm not actually sure she could use this. I don't know if she's thought about that. We didn't talk about it. I mean, like the thing with AIP is like, it is so severe. Like I feel like if seeds are one, she's not exactly sure what her triggers are because she just cut the food out and never put it back. So because it's not worth risking swelling again. But I'm wondering like if she were to put an eye serum on that had an inflammatory for her, are her eyes gonna puff up? I feel like this is a question I need to know the answer to. That was a lot of backstory. I don't know if she's gonna be able to use it. That's the gist. All right, moving on. Next we have the Tarte C Hydro Concealer. So I think I got this as well and I was pretty jazzed about this. Apparently she was not that jazzed about it. I mean, it looks like it would match her shade. She always goes like a slightly shade darker than I do. And especially during the summer, she like is by the pool all the time. So she's gonna be darker. But it looks like a nice shade for her. Definitely, I think would be a little bit too dark for me. It looks a little browner than I am. I'm pretty pale. Yeah, I mean, that's probably the best product I've seen from her box so far. I hope I got one too. I can't remember. But. The next thing we have is the Opera Cool as a Cucumber Primer. And I think she talked about this, like she was excited about it, but then she was like, I think it's like only like $14. So she felt like it just wasn't that good of a value. It is a cucumber primer. I'm a big fan of things with cucumber in it for skincare, especially during the summer when your skin might be like inflamed a little bit because you've been out in the sun. So decent size. I know that this was an option for me and I'm pretty sure I didn't choose to get it because the value was so low on it. So that was one of her complaints with that as well. And then the final thing we have here is from Curlie. It is the Pineapple Bright Gel Cream. And I like Curlie a lot. And I do think that this would be a decent product. I mean, it's a moisturizer and I'm always for moisturizers. But I do understand her complaint. So it's kind of what we've discussed on the channel before. Overall, the bag isn't bad. But at the same time, these were the best options she was given with all of her choices. And this is what she could come up with to assemble. And I think that's why she's so like at her wit's end with it. I'm not positive she won't end up canceling this year because it's really like, she hated it enough that she joined BoxyCharm. She's really just been so displeased with the product she's getting. And like overall, I mean, I actually do like this a lot because it reminds me of, I have a Tarte moisturizer that I got last summer that I really love. It's very lightweight. I feel like this is gonna be the same type thing. The Tarte concealer, I think this is gonna be a good product. The Ofra primer, I think is gonna be a good product. These two kind of throwaways, the eye cream, especially if I don't even know that she can use it, that's gonna be a big factor in it as well. So I don't know. I definitely understand her complaints. Her bag isn't awful, but when you think about like, yeah, this was the best that she could come up with, probably not the best. So, all right, let's look at my bag. I remember being pretty happy with my bag. Honestly, my biggest concern is that I had 3 palettes in it and I always get broken stuff. So I'm worried one of them may be broken. Oh, I didn't say it, but the theme for this month is Do You. I really do like the bag. I think the bag is precious. And it's like that kind of like parachuting material where it's not like canvas, but it's, you know what I'm talking about. You know what I mean. Okay, so the only thing I couldn't remember is I redeemed points a while ago for an eyeshadow palette from Real Her, and I don't think it's the same one, but one of my palette options was from Real Her, and I debated whether I was gonna get it or not because I wasn't sure if I already had it, but I decided to go with it anyway. So this is how wildly different my mom and my bags are, though. It's crazy. Okay. Yeah, oh my God. Yeah, I do remember. I love this one because I got 3 palettes, a concealer, and a foundation. I thought it was a brilliant bag. I was like, I love getting skincare, but it was so nice to see that I could get an all makeup bag. And then you see my mom's bag and you're like, huh, okay. All right, first thing I have here is from, I'm trying to remember what they chose for me. I think they chose the Tarte concealer and I think they chose this palette, but I may be wrong, I don't know. So this is from Vizart. It is a professional makeup company from Paris. This is their Petite Pro Deux. Oh, well, I just put my finger in one of the pots. It's fine, I did it. So it's tiny, but pretty colors. I mean, you get 8 colors, half are matte, half are shimmer. I think this is a great thing for traveling. It's so cute, the way it like folds up. It looks like a little like coin purse almost, like a little like, you know, you're like walking around like with your little clutch or something like that. I don't know, it's precious. I like it. I mean, it's a small palette, but overall, I think it's a great choice for one of the products. So I really like that a lot, and it's not broken, so that's a good sign. All right, next thing we have is the Otherworldly palette from We Are Fluid? Yes. Oh, that's so cool. We Are Fluid is a queer beauty brand created to celebrate underrepresented faces. I love that. I love that, and I love that for Pride Month as well. So I remember this being a really bright palette. Yeah, I'm a big fan of this one. It's actually not as bright as I thought it was gonna be. So you got this like really gorgeous like purple glitter shade, gorgeous green glitter shade, and this gorgeous yellow glitter shade. Then you have like 5 nice matte shades. And it's kind of interesting that they wouldn't give this at least as an option to my mom somewhere, because it's not necessarily something she would choose, but I mean like all of the matte shades I think she would use. I think she would use this. These two are the only ones I think she'd have trouble using, but honestly, I think she would have preferred to at least see it as one of her options than to just not get it. But I love that. And I think it's great that they included that for Pride Month. I think it's so nice to see like, you know, queer owned brands and stuff being represented when obviously Pride is all about celebrating. So last palette we have is from Real Her. I like Real Her. I actually, I didn't start using their products until Ipsy, but I'm a big fan of their stuff. So, and it's funny, I wound up choosing this one. So I ended up getting 2 Real Her products in my box this time around. Oh God, I don't know if this is, it might be the same palette. I don't fucking know. It's a great palette though. If it is, then it'll go in like a giveaway or I'll give it to a friend or something. I don't know. But like it's a good palette. I mean, it's precious. I love it. I'm gonna have to, I really need to go through my makeup. That's the issue, is I just don't even know what I have at this point. Oh, I was gonna break the box, but I didn't have to. So. Yeah, okay, so the Real Her I Am Extraordinary Power Wear Probiotic Foundation. Looks pale, about what I am, so I think this is gonna work. I really like testing foundations. I'm in the process of trying to find like my favorite concealer foundation duo, because I'm trying to think about my wedding makeup, which is in 4 months, and I'm freaking out about that. So I want to like not look cakey, and I want it to like last, and I also want to not have a meltdown while I'm doing my makeup, because like, I mean, the wedding is like 12 people here at our house, so we're planning everything and doing everything ourselves, which means that the last thing I need is my makeup to like stress me out that day. So I've been trying a lot of new foundations lately, trying to find one that I really like, that gives me good coverage, is a good match. It's, right now I'm leaning towards the Pure 4-in-1 because I really like the way that builds on itself. I haven't decided fully yet, but I'm really leaning heavy towards that. But I'm interested to try this baby out here. And then finally, I also got the Tarte C Hydro Concealer. I got it in 12N Fair Neutral. 12N Fair Neutral is what I buy in all of their other shades for any foundation or like their shape tape, you know, all the, that's pretty much how I would go with. Mom's is shade, she got 20B Light Beige. So yeah, hers is definitely darker on the scale than mine by a few, but. And I think these actually look like they would probably match pretty nicely as well, so. I mean, I think hands down, it's pretty simple to choose. I would definitely choose my bag over my mom's. And if I had to pick my 5 favorite products, the only one, because I really think I might already have this palette, I think I would actually opt to get her Purely Moisturizer instead of this, just because I'm not, like looking at it in person, I'm like, I'm pretty sure that's the one that I have, so. Yeah, weird. It's, I mean, it's just very interesting to see like how different our two bags look. I mean, opposites, polar opposites. I got a variety of palettes and, you know, for different uses. She got no palettes offered, nothing, and it, I don't know. What do you guys feel? Are you guys noticing issues like this as well? Are you feeling like maybe even though you've filled out a profile and like customized it, it's not necessarily giving you options that you want? Are you guys happy with it? I'd love to hear what your guys' thoughts on it are. It's gonna be sad if my mom leaves Ipsy because she's been with it, I think, almost as long as I have, maybe even longer. I can't remember if she signed up first or if I did, but we've, like, really within a few months of each other, we've been doing this for years together. And so if she were to decide to cancel her Plus, it would definitely be an adjustment. But at the same time, I can understand her not wanting to spend $25 when she's really not happy with anything she's getting. So if you guys like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you like us, then please subscribe. And other than that, I hope you guys are all safe, healthy, you have a wonderful day, and you stay girly with a dark twist.